E nós estamos alcançando, no momento, 7.800 crianças, semanalmente. Antigamente, antes da pandemia, eram 10 mil. Mas aí, com a pandemia, diminuiu. Estamos voltando devagarinho. Glória a Deus.
Mas 8 mil é muito
alto. Mas o senhor está ótimo. Meu Deus.
Bem, graças a Deus.
All kinds of problems.
Arthritis in my knees. And I had another surgery, so I'm still kind of weak from that. So, yeah.
Had a knee replacement?
No, no knee replacement yet. Morning, Maria.
Is that you?
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Tell me your name again. Carrie. Carrie.
Yeah.
You came to Brazil.
Yes.
Oh my. Yeah. What's your last name, Carrie?
What's that?
Your last name, Henry.
Henry.
How do you spell?
H-E-N-R-Y.
Henry.
Yeah.
I can't remember the last name, but I know you are Carrie.
Yes.
Wow.
So good to see you.
I'm talking to Pastor Lee.
Yeah.
To bring you back.
I want to. Yeah. So I'll get us started.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Today we have a very special guest. We have Maria Gusmao from Brazil. She works with BCM. Gosh, it's been over 10 years now since we went. It was 2012 that a group of us went and helped her at the camp she runs. So there's a lot of things that go on in her ministry in Brazil. We've been supporting Maria since 2010. It was before 2012 timeframe. So Maria is one of our missionaries that we support. We're looking forward to hearing from her today. And I'll turn it over to you, Maria.
Thank you. Good morning. Good morning. Bom dia. Who said bom dia?
Bom dia.
You did. Yeah. Do you speak Portuguese?
Me esporta
brasileira. Oh.
Papai.
Ah, você é o filho de Pastor Lee, o novo pastor da igreja, right?
Sim.
Oh, so, bom dia, pessoal, tudo
bom
bem?
Dia.
It's a pleasure to be here. Let me do my watch here, because I especially know Brazilian people, they speak more than they should. So, it's a pleasure to be here, like I said, and thank you for coming. And I want to start thanking you for praying for me, for helping the ministry in Brazil. And it's really a blessing to have people all over the world together doing, building God's kingdom, right?
Amen.
So we also pray for you in Brazil, some of you. And I believe Alan has been in touch with some of you. Alan is my nephew. He's responsible for getting in touch with the people and getting prayer requests, because every day we have a meeting in the office and we pray for you also. We are a big family of God all over the world. Isn't that wonderful? Well, I have to start taking off my clothes in front of you. I hope you don't mind. It doesn't sound good, right? But I have to do this, okay? Because I will be playing a skit about one of our kids from the Bible class, and his name is Fernando. So I will be playing Fernando's life. And my English is not very good, because I spent 8 years since I came. So I'm trying to bring everything back. If I don't speak good English, forgive me. Okay? So anyways, yes. Yeah, so I will be playing Fernando's life. It's a real story, okay? It's a real story of his life. That's him. See him?
Mm-hmm.
And where's my hat? Yeah, so.
All right.
Well, that's the kids. That's how the kids in Islam, they dress. Anyways, so for now on, I am Fernando. I would like to share with you my story. Well, I'll try to be a little fast because of the time. I live with my stepfather now, but for many years in my life, I lived with my mommy. My stepfather and my mother, they had 8 kids. That time I wasn't born, but my stepfather told me how they lived. Well, we live in a very little house. It's like this size here, and there, 10 people slept. One single bed and one single mattress in the floor for 10 people. It's hard to believe how they could sleep all together, but that's exactly what happened. And my mommy, she had a problem. She loves to drink still and alcohol. And she would spend all day in the street drinking. She didn't care of they didn't take care of the kids. My stepfather had to take care of all the 8 kids they had together. But my mommy got worse and worse and worse and worse. And it became so difficult for my stepfather to continue living with her because she was a mess. She would come home, beat the kids, fight him. It was horrible. And then she ended up falling in love with one drug dealer. What happened was that my mom left all the kids with my stepfather and went to live with this drug dealer. Well, during the time they were together, they had 2 kids, myself and my little brother. That time I didn't know my stepfather, and I was living with my mom in another slum far away from my stepfather. Well, my mom never stopped drinking, and also she got addicted to crack, all kind of thing that you can imagine. And many times she left us alone at home and all day and come back late with my stepfather, both drunk, full of drugs. And even though I was very little, I still remember those remembrances, those things. It was terrible because many times she would come home and beat us up. And even my little brother, I thought it was so mean that my mom would do such thing. You know, she was terrible. Well, they got involved with drugs and stealing, all kind of thing. And guess what happened? They were arrested. They went to prison and left us all by ourselves. That time, I was 6 years old, and I had my little brother with me, and I didn't know what to do. But thanks God that my grandmother came, the mother of my father, came and took my little brother, but she couldn't take me, and she left me all by myself. And I had no idea what I would do, because there I was, by myself. I didn't have food. I didn't have, even though my mom was not very good to us, but still I had a mother that would come back home, and sometimes she would bring us food and stuff. But that time I had nobody, and I felt so alone. I still remember those things when they come to my mind. I never forget them. They keep here all the time. Even now that I live with my stepfather, I still remember that I walk in the street, 6 years old, and I didn't know what to do. And I cried. And I cried that somebody will take me to live with them, but nobody cared about me. And I didn't know there was a God who loved me. And I always said, why my mom had to go? And my father, they were bad, they were not nice to me, but I still have them. And these remembrances still comes to my mind all the time. And I still miss her. I don't think she will ever come back to my stepfather because he doesn't want her anymore because she's mean, but she's still my mother. And I want her to live with me. And then I was there. My grandma didn't want me. I had nobody to help me. And I was there all by myself, hungry. And one night, I was there sleeping on the floor, and I said, I want to die. I don't want it to live. I know it doesn't sound real for a 6-year-old child, but in that time, I had seen so many terrible things. And then, thank God, because guess what? My stepfather got to know that I was all by myself. And he came and he took me to live with him. And I still remember when he came and I said, who are you? And he said, well, I am your stepfather. Your mother lived with me. And he told me some of the things. And he hugged me and he took me to his house. The same house they lived when all the kids were there. But now, when he brought me, nobody was there anymore. They all left. Even my sister, my stepsister, she was already pregnant. She was 12 years old, and they were all over. And so my stepfather wants them to come back, but they run away. I don't know. So many things happened. But then I was there with him. And that time was very good because we had food every day. He worked and he could buy us food. And oh, life was wonderful. There was just one thing that I hated. He wanted me to go to school. And I don't like going to school. Well, the kids, they make fun of me because I'm very little. You know, even though now I am 12 years old, I'm still short. And the kids make fun of me. And I want to beat him up. I already fought so many. Even, you know, when I go to the BCM camp, the kids still make fun of me. And I beat them in the eye. And yes, nobody's going to make fun of me. And my father, he keeps telling me, Fernando, you need to go to school. Fernando, you need to go. That's the only thing that I don't like about my stepfather, you know, because he makes me go to the school. And another thing is, why do I have to go to school? I don't even know how to read. So I really don't care about going to school. I prefer to stay home. Well, when I came, I heard about a Bible club nearby in the slum. And Aunt Dora, she came and she invited me to go to the Bible club. And she said, Fernando, we have snack. I said, whoa, I am going. Because my stepfather got very sick and he lost his job. And then we start having problems with food again. And I said, oh my, we are having this problem again. This is so terrible. But anyways, I started going to this Bible club. I was 6. And then I accept Jesus. Can you believe it? And even though it was so difficult to understand Jesus and God, because, you know, I thought that if God really loved me, why he would allow all this terrible thing to happen to me? And my aunt daughter said, but he still loves you, Fernando, because Jesus died. And she told so many wonderful stories. And even when I go to the camp, they keep telling me. And she always takes me to the camp. She's so nice to me. She thinks that if I go to the camp, I will change. And I really want to change. I know I'm a piece of work because I keep fighting with the guys at the camp. And I'm always in timeout, all the time, crying because when I go back, the kids start make fun of me and I fight and I punch him in the eye. Because yeah, they are terrible. And they say it's my fault. It's not my fault. They are, you know, they are the ones who are bothering me. So, but anyways, and at the camp, we have food. A lot of food. 3 times a day. And also I can play soccer. I love playing soccer. I'm a soccer player. And also, there's something that I also like at the camp. because they talk about Jesus. And every time they challenge the kids to accept Jesus, I raise my hand. Even though they say, Fernando, it's just one time. I don't care. I do every time because I want Jesus to be in my life all the time, all the time. Well, but then I have to come back home. When I come back home from camp, it's always, I really don't like it. But, well, I know that you guys are praying for me, right? Mm-hmm. And now that you know me, you'll be keeping praying for me, right? So that's my hope, that my life will change. I want a job. I want to get a job. I want to help my stepfather. You know, it's not easy, but I want to work. So pray for me. Pray that my stepfather, he just got saved. You know, he accept Jesus with the people that came from BCM, and now that he's saved, and I want to go to the church with him, but he can't really walk because he has back pain, lots. He can hardly walk. But still, if you pray, God can change. Thank you very much. Maria is back. Okay. So I want to show you some of the pictures that I took from Fernando. You see this gold necklace in his, it shows power because the drug dealers in slum, they have those things. And somebody gave, of course, it's not gold, right? It's fake. But still, he wears like he has power. He feels like important. That's why I want to ask you to pray for Fernando. It's not moving. Why? Okay, let's see if I know how to do this here. Okay, this is when he was little. See him? Very little. And that's when he came to my house. He made this bike himself. He's very intelligent. Even though he has problem to learn, but he came, put this piece together and make a bike. Okay? So that's him and his stepfather. And he's wearing his soccer uniform because he plays soccer in the slum. That's where the front of the house. This is inside of the house, just a little bathroom. And you can see the bathroom here. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me go back. And this is the room where they have 10 people sleeping. Now it's only Fernando and his stepfather. Okay, so this is some of the picture. Oh, by the way, this is Antonio, my husband. The one right there, he didn't get his visa. Well, yeah, it's a long story. Okay, so, yeah. What else? What have I done? So that's over. Now I'm going to show you the ministry that we do in Brazil, okay? Shirley, just tell me how many minutes I have, please.
33. 30. Or 44 if you want.
Okay. So now I'm going to talk about the ministry we have in Brazil. And before we start, I already want to invite you to come to Brazil, especially right there. Well, right now he can't come because of Barbara, but if she gets, you know, better and she can come, especially you have to bring back a group to Brazil. And he was a wonderful English teacher. I have my English, even though it sounds so bad, but it's much better after I took classes with Pastor Lee. He's a good teacher, very good teacher. And I hope, guys, that you really can come and spend a week with us in the English camp. I'll talk to you a little bit about the English camp, okay? But the invitation is already done. So, okay, so first we're going to start talking about the evangelism countryside. Am I in your way?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
I am. Okay, where should I be that I will not be in your... Is it bad?
Uh-oh.
No, I lost it. I did?
Uh-huh.
Help me, Robert. Robert. I named him Dave. Since I came, I kept calling him Dave. How's it?
That's the PowerPoint.
Oh, the PowerPoint. Sorry. Okay, so the evangelism countryside. Dr. Bill from East Brandywine Baptist Church comes twice a year, and we go to Sertão. Especially knows this area is a very, very poor area in Brazil, where we do a outreach. The people come to see the doctor. They're very poor. There is no hospital clinics around. And they come to see Dr. Bill. And then everybody that comes, we talk about Jesus and challenge them to accept Jesus. Okay? Is it good now?
No.
What happened? Maybe the PowerPoint. Oh, is it good? Maybe that's the thing. Thank you, Dave. I mean, Robert. Okay, so. Okay, let's go. All right, guys. And then this is the Evangeline countryside. Okay, so we go to these faraway places. And they always have a little church that will take care of the of us. Everybody that comes to see the doctor, we challenge them to accept the Lord. Okay. We also work with the kids. That's one of our teacher, Yasmin, Bible Club teacher. We always bring two Bible Club teachers with us because they work with the kids during the trip. And many of these people have never heard about the gospel because they live very far and not many churches are around. And some of these places we have gone for the first time. We always get in touch with the pastor in the area, and the pastor would find this village. And every day, morning and afternoon, we go to a different village. And then the people come to see the doctor. And the thing is that sometimes Dr. Bill had some very incredible experience, because one time one lady came holding a whole intestine right now, like with a piece of cloth. She had been like that for 1 month and 15 days. She had a surgery in Recife, but the surgeon opened up and she had nobody to take her back to the hospital, and she had her intestine right there. It's unbelievable that she did not get an infection or anything. Unbelievable, because they live in these places. Sometimes most of them don't have water. They have to walk long distance to get water, okay? And sometimes it's a puddle, dirty water. I don't know. It's hard to believe that this thing is still happening in Brazil, but it does. But anyways, yeah, so you can see they come. Sometimes the clinic is outside, because inside the house is very small, so we let the clinic inside so you can see the people. And outside we have the people sitting, and that's when we talk to them about Jesus. That's Dr. Brew right here. You can see him. Okay, he's a very humble man. He sleeps on the floor. He eats whatever. So he comes really to do missions. All right. So we see kids, and that's Deb. He's a nurse. That's Alan. You might remember Alan. He's one of the translator that come with us. Okay, he speaks English. And that's Antonio, my husband. He is the counselor, because after the people hear the gospel, they go to the doctor, and when before they leave, they have to go to the counselor, where they will make sure they accept the Lord or not and challenge them again. They hear the gospel three times. If they don't accept Jesus, maybe they really one day will. So, and then we get the names, and then we give the names to the pastor that will do discipleship afterwards, okay? And then we have the camp ministry. Every January and July, we have the camp ministry. First week of camp is for the small kids, 7 to 12, okay? They come to the camp. And of course, the goal of the camp is to preach the gospel. This is a new camp. You have to come to see the new camp, especially. Mm-hmm. Look at that. Wow. You have to come. I think you took you to see the land, right?
Yes,
see,
you did.
Now you can see the camp, okay? This is the camp. And of course, like I said, the goal of the camp is to preach the gospel to these kids that they come. These kids, they pay to come to the camp. They are not poor kids from Islam. They pay. Okay, and they stay 1 week, and we have different nights. They dress according to the night, you know, And then we have the Bible club teacher. This is Leticia from another state. We have Bible clubs also in Fortaleza. She comes and spends a month with us working at the camp. And then we have the second week. This is for teenagers and young adults. Again, the goal is to preach the gospel. This is Pastor Marcelo, who is preaching. We have preaching in the morning and at night. And this is a very fast horse that we have in the camp. He came from Italy. I got somebody from Italy. Very expensive horse. He walks like that. That time, you could see his face. He's old. But anyway, I'm kidding. Somebody gave me him. And anyways, so we have all this, you know, we have the zip line. We have the climbing tree. So guys, if you come, look, all of these young people, come. We need you, teenagers. You can all come, right, Pastor? You have to go through the requirements. But anyways, yes, so that's the goal of the camp. And then we also have the English camp. That's when I need you guys coming. I have a church that comes every January. It's Calvary Chapel, Chester Spring, from downtown area. So they come every January. But July, we don't have a church that comes every July. So that's why I invite you to come. And you'll be the teachers of the camp, the counselors. And also, I need somebody to preach morning and night. Okay? So that's the English camp. And the goal of the camp, of course, is not to teach English. It's to preach the gospel. But we offer a good English so the people can come. And we have all kind of people coming for this camp. We have, oh my gosh, let me see here if I put my time. Yeah. No, can you tell me again how much time I have? What time am I supposed to finish?
10:30.
10:30? Ah, that's better. Okay, so. Yes, so as I said, we offer them good English, and we have doctors, dentists, simple people like the older people, 87 years old people come to the English camp to learn English. It's a very mixed people. Goes from 15 years old to 100 campers. I mean, age, okay? So, yeah, the goal is really to reach these people with the gospel. You see young people, you see older people. You know, this is Ron. I am staying with him during my time here. And then we have the kids from slum. Remember, we work in slums with kids. I'll talk to you a little bit about it. So these kids, they come, and we have here, Nelly is one of our missionaries. She's putting them in their rooms. We have boys and girls. And then every morning and night, the goal of the camp, again, is to preach the gospel. That's Vanessa, one of our Bible club teacher. And we rent buses to come and bring the kids from the slums. And this is when they arrive, very happy, you know. And they spend the week. Some of them bring very little things. Some of them do not have sheets and towels, toothbrush, toothpaste. But we always have a boutique at the camp, and we always keep sheets and towels for those who do not have. And of course, when they leave, we wash and keep them for next time. And these kids, like I told you, they're very poor. They come from the Bible clubs that we do, okay? So the people who choose who comes are the teachers, Bible club teachers. In January, we have small kids coming. I mean, bigger kids coming, like teenagers, 12 to sometime 18 years old. And in July, we have small kids come, 6 to 12 to 11, you know, something like that. So you can see that they come. They love the camp. This is food time. Of course, a big deal for them. If you remember, and I think you were there, some of you came a little bit earlier, right? And yes, you could see the kids. They love to eat. They eat a lot. Okay? Yep. And then we serve them, you know. They're very sweet kids. Okay, guys? They really... Oh, can you see Fernando in the middle? He's right here. Look at his necklace. Look at him. See? Yep, that's Fernando. Anyways, he always comes because we want to protect Fernando for not getting involved with drugs. Because he lives a very difficult life. Easily, the drug dealers can reach him to be involved with drugs, not to be addicted, to carry drugs, to sell drugs for them. You understand? The problem is, these kids, when they get involved with drugs, if they try, you know, one time, crack, they're going to be addicted. And what happened is, when they get addicted, they're going to use the drug, and they don't have money to pay the drug dealer. And then, guess what happened? They're killed. Just before I came, well, last year, one of our kids got killed. He's 16 years old, he was, right? He was one of our kids. And my sister is the one who does Bible club in his Islam. And before, she knew he was going to be killed, and she found him in the street and prayed with him and asked him, do you know that, have you really accepted Jesus as your Savior? She asked, his name was Luan. And he said he had, and so she prayed with him. She was even scary because they could kill him right there where she was, and she could be also hurt because if anybody comes, they will kill whoever is nearby. So you know they would not anybody's like let's say they would not leave testimony. Testimony is that how I say especially witness. Yes. So. Yeah, but then, of course, he was killed in a very terrible way. I don't want to describe because it's a lot of violence. Anyways, yeah, so pray for Fernando that he will not get involved with drugs. He's still not. But where he lives is all over the place, people selling drugs, and they reach these kids because it's easy to get them selling drugs and taking packs of drugs and stuff like that. Anyways, yeah, so... Of course, they love to play soccer, right? We have to always have soccer in the camp. And then we have the camp for the oldest kids. That is in January, like I said. You see Eagle, this guy with purple hair? He is choose to be killed also. So right now, he lives inside of his house. He doesn't go out. He doesn't go to school or anywhere because... if they find him, they will kill him. And he had accepted the Lord, and we visit him. But even for us to visit him is not safe, just in case they decide to come to the house and do something, you know. So that's Eagle. If you want to pray for him, pray that God will do a miracle in his life, okay? So a lot of these boys, they are already involved with drugs. Right, they sell drugs, they are addicted to drugs, they are thieves, they are the girls, some of them are prostitutes. This is the hardest week because, like I said, this one here, because a lot of these people, they are already involved with all the terrible things that the Islam offer them. All right, so again, Fernando, so you can see him here, he's crying because the camp is over. So and a lot of these kids, they cry. They love to be at the camp. They love to have, well, when they come to the camp, we want to show them we love them. So we hug them, we kiss them. It's very Brazilian to hug and kiss. And we do this with the kids because they don't have this at home. Besides the love, we show them, we feed them, we have games. So they love the camp. They don't want it to go back home. That's why... In the end of the camp, they cry, you know, but of course, we can't keep them, right? So we use this opportunity to share the gospel with unbelievers and to change the face of those who are believers. Camp ministry is certainly a great tool, okay? And then we have the training. We have a training ministry that we train people. This is one of our conferences. We train the people. That's my husband, Antonio Brain. You see him again. Make sure I you know him, right? So this is Pastor James. He's from here, from Strasbourg, his church. Pastor James. I forgot his last name. James what? I don't know his name. I forgot. But anyway, he's from Strasbourg. Yes, he has a church around here. He works with Spanish people. And then the people come and they have the conference. And then we have the Bible clubs. You know the Bible clubs ministry, right? Bible clubs ministry. I was telling Pastor Lee, we used to reach 10,000 kids weekly with Bible clubs. But now, after the pandemic, we are only reaching 7,800. We have 8 teachers. They spend all day in a public school in slums. We do not work with private school, only public schools, right? So this is Jose. She's the coordinator of the Bible Club teachers. We have Mary. We have Vanessa. So we have Dora over there. Dora is my sister. I have my family involved with the ministry. Praise the Lord. So it's Leticia in Fortaleza, another state, Ceará. Where Antonio is from. We have Bible clubs there too. So this is all over. And this Bible club is very different. It's in a bar. You see the bar, the people are drinking. But at night, the owner of the bar let my sister to use the bar. See the bar, my sister here with the kids, and she can get to 200 kids sometime in this place, teaching Bible club. So of course she has people who help. But that's the bar, that's Dora over there, and then some of, you know, the people in the bar. And then we have daycare house where we also do Bible clubs, but they are all in public school, okay? This is Mary. This is some of the houses in the slum that you can see. Most of these slum houses, they are always close to rivers. The people squatter the land. If they see any piece of land and they squat and they build houses, sometimes with bricks, sometimes with piece of piece of wood, like as you can see, sometimes even with piece of cloth, piece of cardboard, depends, you know. So this is some of the slum house. If you see very close, you can see that under this piece of wood there is water. That's the river. They build on the top of the river. So when the river comes out, the house is full of. And this place here is more dirty water. How do you call canal? When they receive, they get, eles têm toda a água que vem dos banheiros, as águas sujas, vai para o canal. E vai para esse lugar aqui. Como que se chama?
Canal.
Canal? Well, all the canal. Water is dirty, bathroom water, and they come up and they smell bad. And it's hard to believe they can live in such a way. This girl was one of Vanessa's Bible club student. She used to go to a Bible club. She's 14 years old. She's already had this baby, and that's her husband. They live in that house that you can see here. Very little place. Okay, see how the houses are? That's the, and this lady, she's doing, this is a little, how do I call this in English? I always forget the name. Especially help me. They call sururu. You know what sururu is? It's a little muscle. Very little, that lives in the dirty water. Terrible. And then she takes them, she cleans them, and she sells. That's sometimes they can make some money to live. Okay? That's a slum, dirty place. And then we have the BCM Brazil office staff. You can see Rosie Lady, she's the coordinator of the Bible Club teacher. Nelly manages the office. Maria Elena, she's my sister. She's the secretary. Alan is my nephew. He is responsible for the discipleship. He also plays on the band. He's the camp program director. And we have Erivelto, he works with all the media. And then we have here, I forgot David. We have Rosemary, Rosie Lady, Pedro, Linda Leticia, Maris Leadora, Gabriel, Vanessa. And then we have Yasmin, who this day was not there. So this is all the Bible Club teacher we have, okay? Thank you very much for prayer attention. This is some prayer requests that you have. I still have 10 minutes, so if you have any question, would you please?
Is this Bible school year round?
Well, we take January and July as a vacation time because we do the camp. So all the Bible clubs go to the camp because July and January, the kids do not have school. It's different from the United States, you know? So that's when we go to the camp and we have everybody there at the camp. Any other question?
Maria, just to explain to everybody, when you cross the equator, the seasons reverse. So we have July and August as our vacation time. For them, it's January and February. Because it reverses when you go south of the equator.
Yes. And where I live is really hot. But your summer is hotter than my summer.
Uh-huh.
Yes, it is. I realize here in the summer is really hot. Brazil is hot, but we have breeze. I mean, where I live, right? Because I live nearby the ocean. I should have the Brazilian. I'm going to put the Brazilian map here so you can see. If you come, I'll take you to the beach. I have to do something to bring the people. I encourage them to come. And I can also give you paçoquita and Brazilian coffee. Paçoquita, you have to come to know what it is. Especially you might know. Any other questions?
I have a question. What does it cost to bring a child to the camp?
To the camp? Right now, I believe it's $110, $120. Anybody else?
How long is the camp?
How long?
Yeah.
The camp from the city?
Yeah, no, I mean, how long does it last?
Oh, 1 month and 3 days, 5 days, depends.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we have 4 weeks of camp for the campers and 1 week, they staff training.
And secondly, do you have a site for that? Where you
we do. MCB, Brazil. I should have put it here, right?
Mm-hmm.
MCB Brazil with S, not Z. .org.
Can you put that on the board?
Yeah.
On the whiteboard.
Over here, Murray.
Over there, Murray. No, 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 no.
Just to explain what Maria is saying in Portuguese, when a Z, an S is between two vowels, it's pronounced like a Z. And so we say Brazil, they say Brazil.
Brazil.
They still pronounce it with a Z because it's between two vowels, the A and the I.
Uh-huh.
Question. What is the attitude toward of the local government toward your ministries? I'm sorry.
It's okay. My president is horrible. He is against everything that comes from God.
Sorry,
he's socialist. You know, he deceives people. Oh, we are Democrat people. We are Democrat. And the people who do not read or do not listen to good,
media,
because they listen to the normal media that are paid to tell good things about them.
Yeah.
So all these people who do not really look for the truth, they are deceived. And they, even though Bolsonaro is from Republic and he's Democrat, and Bolsonaro won the election, but they stole the election. The Democrat people stole and put Lula as the president, of course. He is a thief, he's a liar, he's terrible. I pray for him every day. I was telling how hard it is to pray for this man. It's the hardest thing in my life. And Jim said, just pray for Justin, right, Jim? Because he's so bad. He's like, you know, and all these people, all his people, he's against all of these. But God has, even though he said, we are not allowed to go to the schools and preach the gospel, but we still go. Because the principals, they see the need of God in the schools. Some of these principals, we have lesbian people, they are principals of the school, and they want us there. We have Catholic people who do not care about God, but they still want us there. So it's just God, really. Because, and then we have to be very careful. Some school we cannot pray. Some school we cannot read the Bible, but we can teach the Bible story. Just don't use the Bible, but teach the Bible story. And of course we do it, right? Some schools we are allowed to pray, to teach the Bible, to read the Bible, everything. But it depends on the school. So the Bible club teacher, we prepare them before they go to school. Yeah. Did I answer your question?